Warner breaking news. Take a look at this incredible video of the eye of Hurricane Florence. Now, imagine flying a plane right into that massive Category 4 storm. Maximum winds 140 miles per hour. That's what my next guest did. He's monitoring the storm as it takes aim at the Carolinas, where about a million people have been ordered to evacuate. Many more at risk along the East Coast as Florence gets closer and stronger tonight. Joining me is that brave pilot, Commander Justin Kibbey, a hurricane hunter for NOAA. Commander Kibbey, what were you able to learn from your flight today?
From our flight today, we learned that Florence is getting stronger and stronger by the minute, and it's truly turning into a beast of a storm.
Well, you've been flying in and out of Florence since Saturday. Can you just talk about the changes that you've seen since then?
Sure, yeah. Our first flight Saturday, Florence was just under hurricane strength, and then Sunday it was just over hurricane strength, and today it was a Category 4 storm. So it went from, a tropical storm to a major hurricane in a matter of 72 hours. So it's what they call a rapid intensification. So this storm has really got its act together and is just a heck of a storm out there.
I talked to our meteorologist earlier who was saying, it's a Cat 4 now. He wasn't sure it's going to be able to sustain this. It might kind of fall apart a little bit and then gather strength again. Is that possible?
Yeah, anything's possible. I think us in there taking measurements, the Air Force in there taking measurements, we're going to find out, hopefully instantaneously what this storm's doing before it makes landfall.
How does this storm compare to other storms that you've flown in?
Comparatively to last year, last year was, the busiest hurricane season that I flew. And, this storm it's on par with the storms we flew last year, like Maria and Irma. So it's a powerful storm.
And the eye of this storm, it seems pretty well, well organized is the right term, but it seems pretty distinct.
Absolutely, yeah, it is very well organized. We saw today anywhere from about a 10 to a 12 mile eye that was just absolutely spectacular to be in. Knowing that the power and the damage that those eye walls can do, it's kind of scary. But it is a very powerful storm that's got its act together. So it is no joke storm.
What is it like flying through it?
It is moments of intensity followed by some lulls, but it's a challenging environment for any crew and any pilot.
It's just fascinating what you do, and I appreciate what you do because it allows everybody else to know exactly minute by minute where this thing is and how big it is. So thank you and your crew, Commander Kibbey. Thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you.
The Carolinas have been in this dangerous situation before. Gary Tuchman has that for us tonight.
29 years ago this month, the last Category 4 hurricane to hit the Carolinas. Hurricane Hugo striking just north of Charleston with 140 mile per hour sustained winds. Hugo had already created calamity in the Caribbean, and it continued in South Carolina. More than 20 people were killed in the Palmetto State. The hurricane, which continued down into North Carolina as a Category 2 storm, caused billions of dollars of damage in the Carolinas, where people were stunned by what they saw.
Very, very rough. It was a little rocky. See, the dogs were petrified.
When was this house built?
1790.
Two other Category 4 hurricanes have hit the Carolinas in recorded weather history. Hurricane Hazel struck the North and South Carolina border area 64 years ago in 1954. More than 400 people were killed in Haiti before it hit the U.S. coast. At least 19 people were killed in the Carolinas. 5 years later, another Category 4 hurricane, Gracie, hit southern South Carolina. That storm killed at least 10 people in South Carolina and in Georgia. The last major hurricane of any type to hit the Carolinas was in 1996, Category 3 Fran. The winds, which peaked at 120 miles per hour, made landfall near Cape Fear, North Carolina. 22 people were killed in the U.S., 13 of them in North Carolina. Damage in the Carolinas was estimated to be over $50 billion. It's very rare for major hurricanes to hit the Carolinas. And these words uttered almost 30 years ago during Hugo remain accurate today.
It's just a terrible thing. The storm was extremely severe, Category 4. biggest hurricane the city's had in a century, maybe in its history.
But now, here comes Florence. Gary Tuchman, CNN, New York.